are making their way back to their seats, approaching the start of the second half here between the U.S. and Mexico in the Alamo Dome. William Yarborough, Miguel Ibarra, and Breck Shea, we know for sure, coming off for the U.S. to begin the second half. What about the Mexico side of things? Francisco X. Rivera down on the field.
Hey guys, I spoke to Miguel Herrera at halftime. He told me he needs for his team to shoot more from outside the box. When at the 40th minute, finally Luis Montes got a shot from outside. He went back to the bench. He simply smiled at his assistants and told them it was just about time.
Now Francisco Breck Shea, who grew up about 170 miles away from here, College Station, Texas, kind of marked his resurgence with Orlando City and with the U.S. national team with that great free kick goal in Switzerland a few weeks ago. Miguel Ibarra, the reigning NASL MVP with Minnesota United, who have exciting MLS future in front of them. He replaces Joe Corona, so the whole left side for the U.S. being changed out. Mexico players making their way back out now. Oh, Alexi. Changes on the outside, changes in goal for the U.S. What do you want to see from the Americans in the second half?
I want to see some energy. I want to see some excitement. Look, this is Mexico versus the United States. Oftentimes when we do these games, people say to us or say to me, why are you not more excited? Why isn't your voice more excited? Well, I'm a reflection of what's going on the field.
Who
and the reality is that this has been down. All right? This has not been good so far. We have hope for the future. That future is that second half here. Maybe some of these changes, especially over on that left-hand side, make a difference. We recognize the field's not great. But once again, opportunities for these players to come in.
William Yarborough, as mentioned, second appearance for a young man born and raised in Mexico to American missionary parents. Now with Club León, Luis Montes, a teammate of his. Here come the changes now. Osvaldo Alanis is on for Hiram Mier. And also Julio Cesar Dominguez, who's on for Carlos Salcedo, the former Real Salt Lake defender. So changes at left and right center back in the 3-5-2, 5-3-2, whatever you want to call it, for Miguel Herrera's Mexico. U.S. players are just coming out now. There's Miguel Ibarra. And Breck Shea coming on as well. Six substitutions in total allowed. Three used by the U.S., two by Mexico to begin the second half. So who could go on from this to win? Who can give themselves a boost going towards the Gold Cup? Second half between the U.S. and Mexico is underway. Shea and Ibarra immediately getting their first touches. Ibarra's header in for Jordan Morris. He was able to keep it for Discarute. He's got Yedlin advancing up the right. Yedlin will engage now with Velarde. 1-2 at Discarute. Yedlin has the speed to get there in time. Does not, though, have the touch to get that cross in.
Well, sometimes this man right here has been criticized for his crossing, but I got to give him the benefit of the doubt on that one. That was the field popping up on him. But to get to that position, to get the cross, that was good. The recognition from Mix Discrew to clear out initially on that right-hand side. We know he's fast. And then come in, play the ball in, and then a perfectly weighted pass in. Obviously didn't result in a cross.
Salcedo still in goal. Miguel Herrera saying yesterday he was maybe going to make the change at half for Jonathan Orozco, but that is not the case. Ackerman doing well to keep that off the line. Discarute almost able to get away. Sardis. Ackerman opens it up. Ibarra has Shea calling for it forward. Shea now gets that cross in for Sardis, just too tall. He was in between the defenders. Discarute able to win on the other side. Mitch Discarute fires in the cross. Salcedo gets a touch to a playing safe, and it's cleared away by Velarde. Omar Gonzalez and Kubo Torres battling hard for that U.S. throw.
There are already two great crosses, one from each side. dangerous crosses. Edlin, it was just his second appearance for the U.S. when he played in a game against Mexico this time last year. Parlayed the World Cup into a move to the Premier League. A throw for Zardes. And he's kicked to the chest. Free kick for the U.S. Jose Rodriguez unimpressed. Jossie Zardes down.
This is great work. Putting your body in between the player and the ball. All right. Get paid with the kick to the ribs there, but yeah, he's all right. You're fine. More importantly, you got yourself a foul right there. Good dangerous position. And you frustrate it. You frustrate the defense. And in this particular case, you frustrate a very, very good veteran player in Mazar Rodriguez.
Michael Bradley is over. Everybody back but Kubo Torres to defend this. So Torres is in there. It's Luis Montes who's come forward some. Bradley. Deep to the back post, Gonzalez up to get it. Bouncing header, had to be saved there by Salcedo. Looking to go quick on the punt. Beckerman knocks it away. And Yedlin doing enough to win it back off of Luis Montes. Bradley spins out of traffic. Heavy touch. Gets it away for Zardes. The return takes a deflection. Jordan Morris controls. Jordan Morris has scored! The Stanford University sophomore, his first goal for the United States, gives them the lead over Mexico.
Michael Bradley found a way to get out of pressure here. Nice little turn. And all right, you need a little bit of luck for Jordan Morris. Just follow the play. Be a poacher. Make some history. Welcome, young man. He felt it. He sensed it. Oh, look at you. How good does that feel? For him and for his coach, who had the faith to put him in. And for college soccer, for that matter.
Jurgen Klinsmann told Julie in the pregame about giving Jordan Morris an opportunity, saying, I hope he enjoys every second of this. Well, he's enjoying it an awful lot right now. Seattle area native. Became the first college player to just get on the field for the U.S. since 1995, when he debuted in the fall against the Republic of Ireland. This is his third appearance, and that is something he will probably remember for the rest of his life.
And I'm sure there are college soccer players out there looking at this guy right here and saying, I didn't think he was that good, or I'm better than him, or I marked him out of the game. You know what? It doesn't matter. He got the opportunity, and he took it with both hands. And if that opportunity comes to you, don't worry about who's better or worse. Just take it.
Montes dummies it on, gets it back from Kubo Torres. Easily intercepted that by Ibarra. And Shea just dumps it long for Ibarra to chase. Header knocked down, Morris couldn't control that. Able to win it for Shea.
And these opportunities we talk about, they come in different shapes. And it could be a coach that just sees something and likes you. Could be an injury to a player. Could be a player missing a flight. Anything. But if it comes, be ready for it.
Bradley chasing the loose ball. Mexico trying to control under pressure. Good work to get away from Osvaldo Alanis. Luis Montes loses his footing. Yedlin comes away with the ball. Bradley on the turn. Morris calling for it. Clipped in the air. Morris cycles it back for Discaroo. And Mexico have a player down right now. It's Luis Montes who's down. This is a player who was headed for the World Cup last year when he broke his leg in one of their warm-up games just a few weeks before. 9 months he was out before returning with Club León. This is his first appearance for Mexico since that broken leg for a player that just burst onto the scene in 2013.
Take a look back at this goal here. Michael Bradley, as you said, getting out of traffic there. Jordan Morris, five hole. Yep, you just let up a goal to a college kid.
You see what it means to his teammates. Well, this has been an interesting trend for the U.S. This is since the World Cup in these friendlies. Look at how much they've been outscoring opponents in the first half, how much they've been outscored in the second half. This is the 10th game for the U.S. since the World Cup. It's the ninth time now of those 10 they have had the lead in the second half. They have gone on to win two of those previous eight. Big, big 40 minutes or so upcoming. Montes back out there. Hugo Torres knocked away by Shea. And this has gone dangerous play perhaps for Breck Shea coming from behind.
It's dangerous play, but he had to make this tackle. And he had to pinch in the way he did all the way across more than half field. It's understanding of that left back position. He's getting better and better at it. And he adds those crosses that we've already seen in this game.
Luis Montes to take. The Ghanis are coming forward for Mexico. Everyone but Moore is back to defend for the U.S. Montes swings it deep to the back post. Yarborough gets a fist to it. Now it's got to scramble back. He was chasing a loose ball. The cross is blocked for Ibarra. Out for a throw.
Little things. Blocking that cross. Getting there in time to block it for Ibarra.
Shea steps in to blast it out. Herrera in a real battle with Alvarado. It's going to be a free kick for the U.S. Jurgen Klinsmann, this is his sixth game he's coached against Mexico, unbeaten the previous five, going back to his debut, a 1-1 draw in August of 2011. The last time Mexico beat the U.S. was the game before Bob Bradley's last game in charge, the 2011 Gold Cup final. The U.S. a 2-0 lead, evaporating into a 4-2 loss at the Rose Bowl as Breck Shea gives away a free kick. Second time Herrera's coached against the U.S. That was the draw last year this time in Phoenix. Never played in his appearances, only a handful for Mexico. Never played against the U.S.
Well, at times, many, including myself, have been critical of Klinsmann. You have to ask yourself, would Jordan Morris have scored that goal, be in the position of that, score that goal, if any coach but Jurgen Klinsmann were in charge? I think you can make an argument that no.
Morris almost did enough with Discaru to control that. Hugo Torres and Omar Gonzalez battling. Out off of Yedlin. His header, Yedlin knocks it down. Alvarado had to react, though not happy with his clearance. Discaru gets his head to it. It's Alanis. Discaru able to poke it away from behind. Alanis has it back. It's down to the far side. In the end, comes to nothing. MLS Soccer Sunday returns to Fox Sports 1 this week as international superstar David Villa and New York City FC take on the Portland Timbers live from Yankee Stadium. Coverage begins at 7 p.m. Eastern here on Fox Sports 1, sponsored by Audi. Nick Diskerud will be on the field for New York City in that game. Alexi and I will be there at Yankee Stadium.
Looking forward to it.
There's Diskerud scored the first goal in New York City history in the opener with Orlando. Having played his first 7 years professionally in his home country of Norway, was ironically very close to a move a couple of years ago to the Portland Timbers. Gonzalez can't get there. Luis Montes has the loose ball. Cuts back for Kubo Torres. Scuffs at the shot. Easy save for Yarbrough.
Well, Kubo Torres getting a look. A good clean look. And he just scuffs it. Oh, a little deflection there. Pretty much anything that goes wrong today is going to be blamed on the field. That's how players act.
Good little flick there by Herrera. Luis Montes in a foot race with Alvarado, who's there first.
Again, Alvarado coming over and covering when Omar Gonzalez gets out of that pocket. It's good.
It's going to be a throw. It was very close to that corner flag.
It's good for competition, too. Matt Beasler sitting on the bench looking at his traditional partner, and Omar Gonzalez there playing with somebody else.
Velarde looking for a target. Finds Herrera. Velarde gets the cross into the box. Only Yarbrough's there. This hit ball by Yarbrough given straight back to Mexico in the middle. Up ahead for Kubo Torres. Opening up wide for Velarde. Velarde will fire. Just rising up and out.
And Beckerman's down. Either stepped wrong or got stepped on. But on the turn from Kubo Torres on him after he played it out wide.
Kyle Beckerman, he and Nick Raimondo, 1-2 for active players in MLS with the most appearances. Had to wait to the age of 32 to play in a World Cup. He was at that same under-17 World Cup with Landon Donovan and DeMarcus Beasley. And you don't have to be a doctor to know that just the way they're looking at that knee is not encouraging.
Take a look back here. I'm not sure there was any contact, which is sometimes even worse. He's walking gingerly.
Now that is really discouraging to see Kyle Beckerman walking off like that. Mexico making their third change. Also, Rodriguez is off. Luis Rodriguez is on his debut on his first call-up. Native of Monterrey, and he couldn't make it with his hometown club. And up at Chiapas. He'll press into the midfield.
Well, regardless of what club you play for, if you're a coach or technical director and you see one of your players go down in this game on this surface, you'll be none too happy.
Herrera trying to hold that up. Rolls now for Esquivel. Immediately met by Yedlin, forced backwards.
And not to belabor it, but the 60,000 people here, they deserve better. People watching at home deserve better for a U.S.-Mexico game.
Francisco X. Rivera standing next to Miguel Herrera. Formation change for Mexico?
Yes, sir. Luis Rodriguez will be a holding midfielder alongside Querétaro's Mario Osuna. Mexico now switches to a line of four.
Quickly the cross in. Knocked backwards by Gonzalez. Yarbrough there to grab it. It was Esquivel who came forward up the left. Miguel Herrera made the point yesterday that Mario Osuna normally plays in a two-man defensive midfield unit.
Yep.
So more comfortable position for him. U.S. is still playing with 10, by the way. Beckerman having come off. Harry Kitchen, who's only in the team because Michael Orozco was recalled by his club in Mexico, Puebla. They're in a relegation battle. They didn't really want him coming to this game. And Kitchen's called up as a result first thing Monday morning, and he'll be coming on now. There he is, the D.C. United player, just his second U.S. appearance. A stalwart for D.C. in his fifth year.
And yet another indication that if Michael Bradley's on the field for Jurgen Klinsmann, he is going to be in an advanced position. He's not pulling back. Subbing on another defensive midfielder.
Yedlin was jumping up and down with his arms outstretched trying to get that ball. Rolled in. That's a big bounce off the turf at Diskerud. Forced to return it. Diskerud touch inside. Yedlin able to control on Velarde. And wins the U.S. just their third corner of the night.
Again, that combination of Diskerud and DeAndre Yedlin in tight spaces. Little games within the game.
Michael Bradley, who three times has scored from a corner against Mexico in his career, serving him up tonight. Gonzalez up to get it. Salcedo able to catch in all the traffic. Quickly thrown out for Cubo Torres. Good first touch. Lost his footing. Hard challenge, but clean by Mitch Diskerud. Cubo Torres slow to get up behind the play. Bradley in a real tussle with Osuna. And a foul there. Onibara. And now Bradley and Osuna exchanging words briefly. Referee just stepping in between them. Michael Bradley takes the ensuing free kick. Driven in. Gonzalez trying to hold it up. Almost a second chance at it. Bashed away. Not a lot of work to be done. Just play safe in front of Luis Montes. And the U.S. with a change in the wings will make it now. So a curtain call for Jordan Morris, the goal scorer. What a night for him. A Stanford University college student putting the U.S. up against Mexico. The man to replace him, Juan Agudelo. First, though, a deserved round of applause for Jordan Morris.
We take a look back at what I'm sure in the soccer community has already created the legend that is Mr. Morris right there. If he plays for the national team, he scores.
Esquivel. Line for Velarde. Cross blocked by Yedlin. Out for a throw. Shaking his head in disbelief down there.
It's for real.
Herrera able to keep it just. Velarde spins around on Yedlin. Can't go through him. Esquivel's turn to dance around Diskerud, sends in the cross. Gonzalez off balance, able to get ahead on it. Yedlin work to do on Velarde. Those two both tugging each other's shirts. Velarde stronger. Again trying nutmeg. Can't get through once more. Esquivel, a slip there. Cross sent in now. Cubo Torres headed backwards and cleared away.
As we creep closer to that witching hour for the U.S., up a goal, some pressure coming from the opponent. We've seen it before.
Dominguez, Herrera's touch takes the deflection for Luis Rodriguez. Able to get it wide. Cross sent in back post, and Yedlin well defended there. Yarbrough was scrambling. Luis Montes was lining it up. Good work by Esquivel to pressure Diskerud. It's going to be out for a throw. First, another change for Mexico. Another debut, George Corral. Coming on to replace Serrano Flores. Now the plays at Kinnetano. That's going to be out for a goal kick. Juan Agudelo on the field for the U.S. First time in a little over a year he has played for his national team. And Julie, it's been a long road back for him.
Yeah, John, Agudelo told me when he received an email saying he'd been called up to the U.S. men's national team, it felt like he was getting his very first call-up. It's been over a year, as you said, and he said he's hungry to get back to being a regular starter. And as he was getting back onto the field, Jurgen Klinsmann said to him, "Get me a goal."
Agudelo tried twice and failed to get a work permit to play for Stoke City in the Premier League, was briefly on loan to the Netherlands, spent his fall, as Jurgen Klinsmann said, at times Agudelo wasn't even sure what country he was in. Back with the New England Revolution, back on the field for the U.S.
Jurgen Klinsmann's ordered up a goal. He wants Del Cesaro.
Luis Rodriguez switching it across. Edlin heads away. Diskerud is well in control under pressure. Yedlin long, Agudelo and Zardes both chasing. That's a composed touch by Julio Dominguez. Whistle and a foul there as Hugo Torres goes down. Torres touching inside for Herrera. Around wide for Rodriguez. Zardes able to win it back. That was Kitchen's pressure. Run again by Mexico. Luis Montes. Look at all that space he's got. Alvarado timing his run. The shot is well wide through traffic. All right, Julie, what can you tell us about Kyle Beckerman?
The official word from the medical staff is that it is a left thigh contusion, John.
Well, left thigh contusion is the word. You can see where that ice pack is.
I don't know where Kyle Beckerman's thigh is. He is a wonderful freak, so maybe he has it somewhere different than others.
Zardes is fouled, set off balance there by Mario Osuna. And Michael Bradley will slam on the brakes as we hit 20 minutes to go in the Alamo Dome. Jordan Morris's first goal for the U.S. early in this second half, the difference. Bradley clips it in. Omar Gonzalez, free header, back across, almost found Zardes. Last ditch defending by Julio Cesar Dominguez. Long ball now. Gonzalez can't recover over his shoulder. Flag staying down. Carlos Esquivel dancing to the byline. Esquivel's cross knocked away by Yedlin. Second chance. Esquivel this time in the air. Loose ball cleared away by Ibarra. Morano doing well to control that bouncing ball. Bradley comes to get it. Zardes making the big run. Instead, it's for Juan Agudelo, able to bring it down. He's got the run from Ibarra. Agudelo cutting inside. Juan Agudelo! Dos a cero again!
Well, Jurgen Klinsmann asked for it, and Juan Agudelo provides it. Wonderful first touch. Here's the field, a little bit of a slip. Thank you. It's all right. Use it to your advantage. And boom, near post. What a great little first touch to bring it down. And composure. Recognize. Defenders slipped. Salcedo should do better on that. He doesn't care. Jurgen Klinsmann doesn't care. They don't care. Guess what time it is? Gus is here.
Well, a year in the wilderness for Juan Agudelo. Back to regular playing time in MLS with the New England Revolution back onto the field for the United States. First goal in about 3 years for his national team. For a man who was the youngest ever to score on his debut as a 17-year-old in 2010.
The excuses piling up from the L tree.
Coming inside, and the shot through traffic is wide. Off a slip defensively, and a good look for Luis Montes to score on his return from injury.
Nice little turn here. Ooh, didn't miss by much. But if this score holds, it'll be, oh, the field was horrible. Oh, this was a D team. Every other excuse. But ultimately, it'll be another win for the U.S.
Still a long time to go. Dominguez wins that header, and Rodriguez carries it away. Gonzalez had to track that ball. Edlin driving inside. Sardis and Bradley making runs. Instead, it's for Agudelo. Agudelo in from Discarut. Lost his footing. Dominguez carrying out. Discarut hard shoulder-to-shoulder challenge to win it back. Sardis, Michael Bradley, Agudelo calling for it. That ball's for Ibarra. Agudelo controls the header. Bradley picks it up. Urge to shoot. Closed down, though. Unable to do so. Good defending by Osuna. Long switch for Shea. Not going to reach him. You mentioned, Alexi, the witching hour for the U.S. since June 1st of last year. 15 goals allowed in the final 15 minutes of 15 matches. It has cost them wins against Portugal at the World Cup, Ecuador, Honduras, Denmark, Switzerland. Almost cost them a win against Ghana at the World Cup. The U.S. with a two-goal cushion now. The end of the final 15 minutes as Breck Shea recovers and wins it back off of Luis Rodriguez.
As Jurgen Klinsmann rightly points out, yes, there are different circumstances, different substitution patterns in these friendlies that do contribute it. But they're thinking about it, especially a lot of these guys that maybe haven't been involved to the extent of others.
Early ball for Sardis, too hot to handle.
They're thinking, hey, on my watch, I want it to end. And that's important. It's important for them individually to be a part of that moment when that trend ends.
Rodriguez gets away from Sardis. And pass, though, easily intercepted by DeAndre Yedlin. Discarut for Bradley. It's behind him. Couldn't take it with him. Osuna takes it off him. Luis Rodriguez in space there. Instead, it's played square and wide for the advancing Corral. Corral again. For Herrera. Rodriguez. Corral. Good combination this. Ibarra flying in from behind, and it's going to be out for a Mexico corner, their fourth of the game.
Klinsmann waving DeAndre Yedlin to come upfield, provide an outlet as it swung an easy header away for Bradley Rodriguez. Back through traffic and nowhere near.
U.S. will take that all day. Talked about that zonal type of marking. Not even a challenge on that one.
Well, Michael Bradley tonight with an inexperienced team around him, wearing the armband. The assist on the Agudelo goal, number 13 of his career, to match his total number of goals. What has he meant on the field amidst this larger debate of where his best role is?
Well, the debate continues. As far as I'm concerned, and I said this before, I think that he is mediocre in an advanced position. I think he's world-class in a withdrawn position in the midfield. We disagree in terms of him and Jurgen Klinsmann and I.
Diskerud.
But tonight,
clearance.
I think he's been very good. The same type of work ethic and running.
Reverse for Bradley.
And making himself available.
Out for a U.S. corner.
And Michael Bradley's a smart guy. He's going to figure out how to use his best qualities in the position that Jurgen Klinsmann puts him in.
Well, they're stacking players right in front of Saucedo, the goalkeeper. Bradley trying to drop it in on that near post. It's cleared off the line. That is exactly what they were trying out of that set piece. Inches away from 3-0. Into the space. Agudelo able to get there in time. U.S. throw.
Hey, Trace Azero sounds good, too. And going back to Michael Bradley. As I said, this is a smart player. And I think when he's most honest with himself, even he maybe recognizes where his best position is. But he's going to do what the coach is going to tell him to do. And, look, he loves to attack. But he's going to adjust it to his qualities. And oftentimes tonight, we've seen him drop back where he's most comfortable.
Mexico making the change. Luis Montes in his long-awaited return to the national team. Pulled off for Antonio Rios, who had about 4 years between Mexico appearances last fall. Diskerud cuts it back. The shot through traffic is saved. That never got to Salcedo. That was Perry Kitchen's effort. Scored twice over the weekend for DC United. Almost opened up his U.S. account. Another American throw. Kitchen has played at every youth level for the U.S. U-17, U-20s, U-23s finally broke through against Panama off of the January camp. Change for the U.S. Nick Diskerud giving a curtain call. Brad Evans is on. First appearance since February of last year for a player who was one of the last cuts for the World Cup.
And he's going to come in at right back, push DeAndre Yedlin up to more attacking midfield right position.
Agudelo keeps that in, intercepted before it found Zardes. Good defending by Dominguez and clear. Yedlin recovering there. As Esquivel thought he'd gotten away with something. Bradley, pocket picked. Passed forward by Omar Gonzalez. Knocked down, almost fell for Ibarra there. Corral and Dominguez, and Dominguez caught by his own teammate, slow to get up. Kitchen. Bradley controls it. Shea can't find Zardes. Agudelo almost won that. Essentially did win it. U.S. throw. Mexico preparing their sixth and final substitution in the wings. Yedlin, look at that speed. Just out, though. And here comes the final change for Mexico, and it will be another debut. Marco Bueno made his name at the 2011 Under-17 World Cup, played Under-20 World Cup as well. He's been on loan at Toluca this season. This is his first call-up and his first appearance for the national team as he replaces Eduardo Herrera. Gonzalez keeps that in. Bradley immediately under pressure, able to keep it. Wide and across for Breck Shea, charging forward. Shea needs some help now. Finds Ibarra. Shea got away from one, not a second. Again, playing long for Jossie Zardes to chase. Dominguez there running with him. Zardes able to win that ball. Zardes coming inside. Play central for Bradley. Poked away from behind. Good defensive work by Antonio Rios and a hard collision between Luis Rodriguez and Michael Bradley. Kitchen and Bradley helped to win it back. Kitchen the return for Jossie Zardes to chase. Intercepted and kept in play by Dominguez. Good little touch out wide by Esquivel. Long ball too far for Kubo Torres. Well, this is the last six matches, so in Jurgen Klinsmann's reign, huge edge in shots, passes in the attacking third, and yet the goals and the results have gone the way of the United States and are going that way again with still 5 minutes in stoppage time to play. Torres winning the header in front of Gonzalez. Bueno able to control it on Alvarado. Goes back out wide for Carlos Esquivel. Mexico not done yet. Esquivel engaging with Evans. Evans goes to ground, wins the ball. Energy that was pulsating through so much of this game from this majority pro-Mexico crowd has subsided a bit, particularly since Juan Agudelo's 72nd minute goal to make it 2-0. So just juggling that ball to keep it, put Breck Shea in a tough position though, quickly ahead. And on the turn, it's Kubo Torres. Bueno running for him. It's a bit behind him, and he loses his footing trying to chase it. Shea's clearance straight back, though, to Rios.
Well, Jurgen Klinsmann deserves full credit for the decisions that he made. Obviously, Jordan Morris, and then the substitution with Juan Agudelo, they've paid off. And that's what we judge coaches on. Can you affect change with the things you start with and the way you adjust and change?
Well, that switch from Shea for Yedlin will work, just barely. Yedlin coming forward. He'll engage now with Velarde. Yedlin to the byline. Wins the corner for the U.S. And it should be noted, both those players, Morris and Agudelo, are they in this team? Are they on the field? If not for the absences of Clint Dempsey and Jozy Altidore.
Well, we've talked so much about opportunity. Man's misfortune, it's another man's opportunity. Or woman's.
How much will this factor into Jurgen Klinsmann's decision making ahead of what is a massive gold cup. Chance to win a spot on the Confederations Cup in Russia. Bradley's corner up to get it. His kitchen to the traffic. It's going to be well wide. Alvarado, in fact. You heard the roar a moment ago. 64,369. Jammed into the Alamo Dome tonight. Largest crowd ever. To see a soccer match in this building, besting by about 10,000, the crowd that came to see Mexico and South Korea last January. And waving goodbye to the Mexico fans, a good number of whom all of a sudden are making their way to the exits. Sardis and Agudelo battling. Alvarado had to track down the lights.
He's done well all night, Alvarado. Real good option for Jurgen Klinsmann going forward.
Ibarra accelerating, has Shea to the outside. Ibarra wants this one himself, gets a cross away, was partially deflected, and Salcedo along to come grab it. Heavy touch in the middle by Rios. Ibarra wins it back for the U.S.
Not enough U.S. soccer fans here to start Olaying, but in my mind, I'm Olaying.
Flag is up for a foul on Juan Agudelo, holding off Efrén Villarde.
And that's nothing against the folks that did show up, including the Outlaws down there, who always show up.
Now, next for the U.S., a pair of very challenging friendlies on the road at the beginning of June at the Netherlands and at defending World Cup champions Germany June 10th here on Fox Sports 1. The Gold Cup then, as you can see on Fox Sports, beginning July 7th. Mexico is the Copa America in June, then the Gold Cup right on the back of that. This is clipped in. Kubo Torres chasing. Gonzalez got a piece of it. Torres losing his footing. Bueno in there as well. Yarbrough able to grab it. But it's a big year for the United States. Under 20 World Cup coming up before too long. Under 17 World Cup in the fall. Olympic qualifying on the horizon. World Cup qualifying for Russia begins in November, earliest it ever has. And again, how badly they want to win the Gold Cup. Avoid that one game playoff for a spot on the Confederations Cup in a couple of years in Russia. And 2015 that was sort of sputtering in the last couple of weeks, with the losses in Denmark and Switzerland. As we enter into stoppage time, 3 minutes still left on the watch of referee Ricardo Montero. This, regardless of whatever circumstances, who's on the field, what the field's like, this is a needed jump start for the United States. Can they see it out cleanly, though, and continue the legend? Carlos Esquivel on the ball. A slip from Kubo Torres allows Omar Gonzalez to clear. Rios rolled in. Good work by Evans to win it back. Bradley hit too far on that one for Jossi Zardes.
John, we're looking at these players and who have helped themselves. Jossi Zardes, he might not have been goal dangerous on a consistent basis here today, but he has run all over the place. And not just pointless running. Runs to track down balls to keep a hold of the ball. Runs to put pressure. Runs to take effort, mental and physical effort. You don't have to do those runs, but he's doing them.
Yedlin, Kitchen, trying to scoop that ball out. Whistle and a foul on Luis Rodriguez. players will go back to their clubs for MLS and Liga MX action this weekend, or NASL in the case of Miguel Ibarra.
Yep.
Or back to class for Jordan Morris.
Yep.
What do you think that's going to be like, sitting in his first class after this?
I hope he brought his books. But regardless of the circumstances, and we will talk about the circumstances, whether we want to or not, it is a win. It's a win against your arch rival. Neither team at full strength. So far, so good in terms of letting up late goals. Once again, that classic scoreline, 2-0. Some individual performances that I think Jurgen Klinsmann can look to for the future. Some players he already knew about, but just confirmed. And maybe some stars of the future, maybe even near future.
Final seconds here. Bradley takes the free kick. Omar Gonzalez too tall for him. Referee Ricardo Montero looking at his watch. Shea keeps it in play, but that's it. The legend that began that cold night in 2001 in Columbus continues here in the Alamo Dome. Jordan Morris, his first goal for the United States. Juan Agudelo, his first goal on his first appearance in a little over a year. 2-0 once again. Jurgen Klinsmann in the United States over Mexico. Let's go down to the field. Julie Stewart-Binks.
Thank you so much, Sean. Jordan, your first start for the U.S. men's national team and your first goal at this level in front of 64,000 people. What was that moment like when you scored against your arch rival?
It's hard to describe. You know, it's a really emotional game. Obviously, anytime we play Mexico, they're a big rival of ours. And, you know, scoring a goal against them is something I dreamed about since I was a little kid. So to make it happen is unbelievable.
A huge statement game for the United States tonight, being able to extend the lead and hold it to the very end. How would you say your entire team was able to contribute to this victory?
Yeah, I mean, it was an unbelievable team effort. We from the back line all the way up to the forwards, everyone's working hard the whole 90 minutes. And, you know, that's our mentality is that, you know, we're going to outwork the other teams. So we just go out there and stick to that. And I think we did that really well today. Everyone contributed, and it worked out.
Thank you so much. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Julie, a lifetime memory for Jordan Morris. Big smiles for all these United States players. Fox Sports Live is coming up next, but we're coming right back to the Alamo Dome for so much more reaction and analysis as this one finishes. United States 2, Mexico 0.